Let's say this is one loop, right? So this, assume that this is a circular loop. And let's say you have another loop. So they are saying it is concentric and then it is perpendicular. So usually when you say concentric, you would think one above the other one, right? That's what I would think concentric means. But here they are saying it's perpendicular to each other, which means I think I should assume it like this. So are you able to understand what I'm saying? So since it is 3D, you have to think a lot. It's not as easy as you do the 2D problems. So imagine this is one loop. So the other loop is like this. Okay. So if I take this loop, which way is the magnetic field? The current is flowing like this, you can say that the magnetic field is like this. And if I take another loop, let's say this is another loop which is perpendicular to this, let's assume that the current is going like this. So that means which way is the magnetic field? This way. So due to this one, the magnetic field is this way. Due to this, the magnetic field is this way. So two forces are acting at the same time, right? And what should you do? You should do 5 kg plus 2 kg is 5 newton plus 2 newton is. They've been telling this right from 11th standard, still you say 7 newton, right? So it depends upon the direction, right? So you cannot add it like 5 plus 2, right? If it was in the same direction, 5 plus 2 is true. If it was 5 this way, 2 this way, it will be 3, right? If it was 5 this way, 2 this way, then it is Pythagoras theorem, right? If it is 5 this way and then 2 this way, what should you do? Parallelogram law of vectors. So I'm sure you have studied some formula for this. Okay. Luckily in these cases, since it is perpendicular, right, most of the time you will not be using this one. Okay, so you don't have to remember this for now. But you will be using the a square plus b square formula. So is that clear? Are you following the 3D thing, right? So if you understand that, it's very easy. So let's see the coil P, right? So let's say the coil P is like this. They didn't give you the direction, but I'm going to assume that it's like this. So that means at this point, it's going to be magnetic field due to P, right? B is magnetic field, P is due to P, right? And then let's say XY and YZ. So I think I drew a drawing something like this, right? X, Y, Z. So in XY plane, this is line, right? Okay. And that is 1 amp current. Okay, that is P coil. So look at this. If the current is going like this, which way is the magnetic field? Magnetic field will be here. So this will be magnetic field due to P, right? Because it's lying in XY plane, which means it's going to be like this. Read the next sentence. It is YZ, right? So the next loop is kept at YZ. So YZ is Y and Z. So it's going to be like this. Maybe I should try to use a different color. So imagine I have another loop like this, right? Again, the question is not correct. They didn't give you the proper direction. It can be like this or it can be like this. So I'm going to assume like this. So if it is like this, which way is the magnetic field? It will be like this. So BQ. So this is Q. The magnetic loop root A. So the current through this is root 3A. So here it is 1 amp, here it is root 3 amps. Right? So find out this value separately, find out this value separately. After that, it becomes very simple. So this is BP, this is BQ, find out the resultant. So you know the formula for magnetic field at the center, right? What is the formula? Mu naught I by 2A. Very good. So if you don't know that, you know, generally I don't remember that. I always remember only the main formula. So mu naught by 4 pi I 2 pi A square divided by A square plus X square power 3 by 2. This is the main formula which you have derived when you have a distance of X. But here it is center, which means this is gone. So a cube a square cancels, 2 pi cancels, so you will get mu naught by 2 I by A. Okay, B at the center. Okay, is that clear? So simply apply this. So BP will be mu naught I is 1 amps divided by 2 A. Did they give any radius? No radius is given, so capital R. So it's 2 capital R. BQ is equal to same formula, mu naught root 3 divided by 2R. Right? Simply I am applying that formula here. Any doubts so far? After that it's simple. Pythagoras theorem. Right? So if I want the resultant R, right? Or I can call it as BR. So this is magnetic field due to Q, this is magnetic field due to P, this is magnetic field resultant. So BR is equal to square root of BP squared plus BQ squared. So look at this. This square means it will be mu naught. So can I write it here so that everyone can see it? So BR is equal to square root of BP squared plus BQ squared. So BP is mu naught by 2R, the whole squared, plus mu naught by root 3 2R, the whole square. So what can I take commonly out? Mu naught by 2R, the whole square, and when it comes out of the square root, the square will also be gone. So that means this can be taken out commonly. What is remaining is 1 square plus root 3 square. Is that correct? If you have any doubts, do this yourself, you will get this answer. So mu naught by 2R, this is 1 plus 4 is, so 1 plus 3 is 4, so 2, so 2, 2 cancels, so you will get mu naught by R. Mu naught is a constant, right? Anybody remember the value for mu naught? We said mu naught by 4 pi is given as 10 power minus 7. So if I want mu naught, what should I do? 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 divided by R. So that's your answer. So I think you can leave it like this. But force due to magnetic field, right? Or the magnetic field itself, is it a vector or scalar? Vector, right? Because it has got a direction, otherwise you would not draw this at all, right? Have you ever drawn, like, you know, 5 kg this way, 2 kg this way? Will it make any sense? Because it's a scalar, right? It doesn't make sense. So whenever you are drawing a direction, it means it has got a direction to it, right? So I found the magnitude, how to find the direction, this eta. Tan theta is equal to this by this, opposite by adjacent. So what is opposite? If this is BP, this is also BP. So tan theta is equal to BP by BQ. So BP is, just now we found this, mu naught by 2R divided by BQ is mu naught root 3 2R. So mu naught 2R cancels. So what is remaining is 1 by root 3. Where do you get 1 by root 3 in tan theta? 30, right? Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So that means theta is equal to 30 degrees. That's your answer. So that's your direction. But while giving this, good practice is to say that 30 degree with, is it 30 degree with BP or BQ? BQ. So you should say 30 degree with respect to BQ, because somebody else may be doing something else. They may be finding this angle. They would say 60 degree with respect to BP. Both are correct answers, right? So this is with respect to BQ. Two long coaxial insulator solenoids S1 and S2 of equal length are wound one over the other as shown in the figure. A steady current I flows through the inner solenoid to other end B, which is connected to the outer solenoid S2, through which the sum current I flows in the opposite direction so as to come out at end A. Okay, so what they are trying to show here is, so there is a big solenoid here. It shows the current is going like this. So that's a big solenoid. But the wire is going here and then it doesn't stop here. So from here again you are winding like this. So that means here the current is coming like this. So please listen carefully. This way for the outer solenoid the direction is this way, right? For the inner solenoid it is this way. So what can you say about that? What's going to happen to the magnetic fields? Both will be in same direction or opposite direction? Opposite, right? So I told you have to go by the curling fingers. So if it is curling like this, so look at the thumb. So north is going to be on this side. So for the outer thing, north is going to be here. For the inner thing, right? So they said it is going in the opposite direction. So look at this. If I curl it like this, north is this way. So that means magnetic field due to this and magnetic field due to this, both are in opposite direction. Both are at the same center line here. Do you agree? Center of this is this line, center of this is also this line. So they are asking you to find the magnetic field at the center, inside the axis. In the outer one, they said the number of turns is N1. Inner one it is N2. Okay. So the first thing to understand is the direction. Once you understand the direction after this, it's very simple. So let's talk about B1. What is the formula? B is equal to solenoid formula. B is equal to mu naught Ni, right? So mu naught Ni. Here they said N1, so I'm going to say N1. And they said it is capital I, so I'm just going to substitute it here. Or let's go by the formula first. So mu naught N1 I. So I hope everyone understood the question properly. So they said this is wound and then the same wire is wound like this, which means it's a continuous wire. It's not two different solenoids, right? So that means whatever current is flowing here is actually flowing here also, which means I is same in both the solenoids. Is that clear, everyone? So what about B2? B2 is equal to mu naught N2 I. Right. So we said we are going to find the difference. So it's like 5 Newton somebody pushing this way and 2 Newton pushing this way, which means 5 minus 2. So that means I don't have to use Pythagoras theorem. I can just simply use B resultant is equal to B1 minus B2. So it's going to be mu naught N1 I minus mu naught N2 I. So what is common? Mu naught I is common, so N1 minus N2 is your answer, that's all. Was that very difficult? Just simple application of formula and then finding out the direction and then saying that it is opposite, right? But the same question when it is asked in the exam, what will you do? Oh, it looks very complicated. So I don't know how to do this, so just leave it. Okay. I've seen many students doing that. Very simple problems. They think that it is very complicated and then leave it. So that is for inside the axis. So this is for the first one. Second one, outside the combined system. What do you mean by outside? So somewhere here, what is the magnetic field? Zero, right? Remember when we did the derivation, we said something which is outside, far away from here, we assumed it as zero. Right, so here also you have to say that, you know, most of the magnetic field is concentrated inside the axis, right, inside the solenoid, and whatever is outside it will be very very little, so it's very negligible, so we can say it is zero. So the magnetic field outside is zero. Long straight wire of circular cross section of radius A carrying steady current I. The current I is uniformly distributed across this cross section. Derive the expressions for the magnetic field in the region R less than A, R greater than A. Okay, so what they are saying is there is a, let's assume there is a big rod like this. Okay, so they are saying there is current flowing through this, which is I. So it is evenly distributed. So the current is going even. So if it is 1 amp here, here also it is 1 amp. So everywhere it is 1 amp. So the total will be addition of all these things, right? That is what is even flow, right? So that means it's something like a ratio, right? So if I tell you for 1 meter square, how much current is flowing? Let's say if I said for 1 meter square, it is 2 amp current. So for 2 meter square, how much is that? 2 into 2, that's all. So it's just a ratio thing, right? So that's what they are saying. So it's kind of equally distributed here. I is equally distributed. So now they are asking, right? So what if I take some kind of R? So the current is flowing like this. So if I take a point here, what will be the magnetic field? So can I, so imagine that I draw a line like this, okay? Again, I can't show this in the board, so the only way I can show this is I have to show it like this, like a three-dimensional circle going around it. Why? So if the magnetic field here is say 10 units, here also it will be 10, here also it is 10, because the radius is same everywhere, right? So what law can I use here? I know a current inside and I want the magnetic field outside. Which law? Ampere's circuit law. So remember that integral of B dot dl is equal to mu naught I enclosed. What do you mean by I enclosed? Current inside the loop. So there is a current enclosed inside this. Magnetic field B is same everywhere. What will be the integral of dl? 2 pi r, right? So B is same everywhere. Integral of dl is nothing but 2 pi r. So mu naught capital I, because if I add all these current, right, they said it is current I. So that means I enclosed is I. Current enclosed is I. So if I want B, I can say mu naught I divided by 2 pi r. So that is for, I think, this is for the case where you have case R is greater than A. What is A? So A is the radius of this conductor. Okay. The diagram is very confusing, right? Because they have shown one conductor like this. And then they are shown the diagram in this way. So what they are trying to say is they are showing the cross section when you are seeing it from this side. Okay, so don't get confused with the diagram. It's the same meaning. Anybody having difficulty in the diagram? So it's a cross section which is shown here. And then they are showing that what is the magnetic field inside A and what is the magnetic field outside A. That's what I am trying to show here. Still not bought the book? Why? You have to buy it. Yeah. So R is greater than A was very easy because I enclosed is everything, right? But what about R inside A? R less than A. So suppose if I take the case R less than A. Any idea how to do this? So let me redraw this one more time here. So I want the magnetic field at this point, B. Yeah, as I said, it's a three-dimensional curve, so it should go like this, but this is the best I can show here. So that means so let's follow the same rule. So integral of B dot dl is equal to mu naught I enclosed. So carefully listen here, it's a little bit confusing. So this is R, this is A. Do you agree? So the rod radius is A. The external radius which we took was R. But now if the R was smaller than A, the diagram will look something like this. So this answer will be different from this one. Why? Because the I enclosed, is it, this entire area is not enclosed here, only this area alone is enclosed. Are you able to imagine what I am saying? The formula says I enclosed, right? So if I want the magnetic field at this line, the current enclosed, these are the currents flowing here is actually outside the loop. So only inside this it is enclosed. Enclosed means inside the loop, right? Inside this B part. So that means I know for this entire area the current flowing is A, sorry I. So what is the area of this cross section? Pi A squared, right? For carefully listen, for pi A squared area it is I. For this area, what is the area of this one? Pi R squared. So for pi A squared it is this much. For pi r square, how much it is? So it's I told you it's a ratio thing, right? For 1 meter square, if it is 2 amps, for 2 meter square, it will be 4 amps into 2. Similarly, this is for the entire area. So for the entire area, the current flowing is I. So that means for this much area, it will be less than that. If the area is smaller, current will also be lower. Everyone following that? So if you understand that, that's all. So I enclosed is there, so I put it here. After that, it's all same. So B integral of dl. So integral of dl is again 2 pi r. So nothing different there. Mu I enclosed is this much. I by pi a squared pi r squared. So remember we are doing r less than a. So pi pi cancels. So mu naught I r squared by a squared. So this R and this R are same, so I can cancel one of the R. So I'm going to get B is equal to mu naught I by okay. Any doubts? I by pi a square. Okay. It's like saying, okay, for let's say a simple example is, let's say for total marks of 50, you got 35. So for how 100, how much is it? How did you do that? For 50, it is 35. For 100, so for this area, I am flowing a current of I. For this area, how much it is? Right? So suppose if I want to convert it to 25, I would multiply by 25. Right? Half of 35 would be. That's the meaning. That's what I said, you know, simple ratio. Okay. So very often you'll be using this kind of technique. So make sure you are understanding this very well. Only if you ask me, I will understand now what kind of doubts you have. If you don't ask me, I'm assuming that you folks are very well, you know, understanding everything. This here, anybody having still doubts that how I got that area thing? Any idea how to link this and this? How can I double check whether my answer there is correct or wrong? equate. No. When will both will be equal? When this r becomes small, bigger and bigger, when it reaches a, right? The radius will be r is equal to a. So suppose if I put r is equal to a cancels, which means mu naught I by 2 pi a, mu naught I by 2 pi r. It's the same thing, right? Because in this case r is equal to a, right? So make a note. So these kind of questions, it's a very good double check, you know. If you are double checking it, you will not make any mistakes. So when r is equal to a, if you use that, you will get mu naught I a by 2 pi a squared. So a cancels, so you get mu naught I by 2 pi a, which is same as this one. So that means I can be confident that this answer is correct, whatever I got there. Okay. So this is a very important type of problem, okay. So very often you will get this, particularly in your competitive exams, you will get this. You can see 17 is also exactly the same thing, so I am not going to repeat that. So the current loop is going like this. So what can you say? So it's going like this, which means at this point the magnetic field is going to be like this, because north is this way, right? So the magnetic field due to this, let's call it as 1 and this as 2. So due to 1, it will be this way. So again, you know, in the 3D it's going to be a little bit difficult for me to show. So imagine that it's going like this, it's into the paper. That means look at the thumb. Right? So the magnetic field is this way. Right? Because this is north means this will be the direction. So they are asking you to find the magnetic field at. So the earlier question, they asked you to find the magnetic field at the center point. So both the center were at the same point here. Now they are just moved it here. So that means you should use the current loop. So magnetic field due to a current loop in its axis formula. A squared plus x squared power 3 by 2, that formula you have to use. So you know how to find that one. What about this one? So the current, again there is some printing error. So I think its current is given like this. So look at this. So the magnetic field is this way. So that means, so what do? Pythagoras theorem, right? So find out the resultant, that's all. So you should know how to do this and this and find out the values. So take down this and, you know, try it yourself. But I feel like there is some data missing, but you can check it out. But as long as you understand the concept, that's fine. So state by Ch4 law, expressing it in the vector form, so you know how to do that. Use it to obtain the expression for the magnetic field at an axial point D from the center of a circular coil of radius A carrying current I. So that's the derivation which you have done already, right? Also find the ratio of magnitudes of the magnetic field of this coil at the center and at an axial point of, for which D is equal to A root 3. So B is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I 2 pi a squared divided by a squared plus x squared power 3 by 2. So this formula you may have to remember it. Okay. So if you start deriving it every time, you will not have time. So you have to remember this. So find the ratio of magnitudes of the magnetic field at the center. So that means they are asking you B at center divided by B at a distance. So B at center means we said mu naught by 2 I by A. Is that correct? Remember this? We substituted x is equal to 0, we got A cube, A square cancels, so you will get this one. So that's for the center point, right, at this point. So now they are asking that with ratio of distance equal to a root 3. So d is equal to a root 3. So what am I supposed to do? This distance is given as a root 3. So what should I do? I should substitute in place of x, right? In the derivation which we used, x is our distance. So substitute it and find out what you are getting. So mu naught by 4 pi I 2 pi a squared. So did they give any radius value? Radius is given as a, so I will leave it as a. So a 2 pi a squared divided by a squared plus x is a root 3. So that means a root 3 the whole square is a squared 3 a squared power 3 by 2. So mu naught cancels, I cancels, 2a, yeah, so I can cancel this 2 and this 2, then I can cancel this 2 and this 2, pi pi cancels, so this will become 4a squared, so 4a squared 3 by 2, so this goes on the top, so 4a squared power 3 by 2, so let's go step by step. Then this goes on the top, this is on the bottom. So I have a here, a squared here. So this a squared will come here. So it will be a squared. Want me to write on the top? Okay, so Javin, up to this, are you able to see? Okay, so let me rewrite this. So I'm getting 4a squared power 3 by 2. I have a here, so very often I have seen you folks making mistakes. So look at this. This is a fraction, this is another fraction. So this should go on the top, this should go to the denominator. Very simple things, but you will be making mistakes here. So a is here, a squared comes here. So this is square square cancels, so it will become a cube. I have a cube in the bottom, cancels. 4 power 3 by 2. How to do that properly? So 4 power 1 by 2 power 3. That's how I can do it very easily. Right? So 4 power 1 by 2 is square root, which is 2. So 2 power 3 is 8. So since the question says ratio, right? Instead of writing it as 8, a better answer would be 8 is to 1. Because this is like having 8 by 1, right? So this by this. So that means the ratio of B center to B distance is equal to 8 by 1. So it's equal to 8 is to 1. So is the magnetic field stronger here or here? At the center it is more stronger, right? Which makes sense. If your answer was 1 by 8, that means you have done something wrong, right? But whenever we say ratio, you should know, suppose if I had taken B distance by B center, then the answer would be 1 by 8, right? Makes sense. So 22 is theory, 23 is theory, so all these toroid, solenoid, all those questions which you are already aware of. But at least go through the questions, right? So you should know what kind of questions they are asking in the board exams. Go to 25, do the third one. The first two are theory, so you can study it yourself. So I think we have done a similar problem in the previous class, right? Semicircular loop. So how to find the magnetic field due to semicircular loop? You know, for one full circle is this formula, right? Mu naught I by 2a. So for half circle it will be divided by 2, which means it will be 4. Mu naught 4 ia by I by a. Okay? So you don't have to mug up the formulas. You know the logic, you can always arrive at it. So if I know this, I can arrive at this. If I know this, I can arrive at the semicircular loop. So as far as possible, try to don't remember too many formulas. Okay? So try to remember only the required formulas. A straight wire carrying a current of 12 amps is bent into semicircular arc of radius 2 centimeters. So you have a semicircular arc. So the current is flowing here, it's flowing here, and it's flowing here. So same current. So they said it is 12 amp current. Radius of 2 centimeters. What is the magnetic field B due to the semicircular thing? B at O due to semicircular loop, semicircle is equal to mu naught by 4 I by A. So mu naught by 4, I is 12 amps, A is radius. So can I put 2 or should I do something else? Centimeter, is that okay for us? So I have to, all these formulas you should substitute only in SAS. So that means 2 divided by 100 to convert it to meters. So if you leave that, then your answer will be wrong. So this goes on the top. So this, so this is 6, 3 by 2, 300, yeah. So it's 150, right? So mu naught 150. So what did we say about mu naught earlier? Mu naught by 4 pi is 10 power minus 7. So that means mu naught will be 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 into 150. So whatever that is, I think 4 into 15 will give you 60. So 60 0 to 600 into 600 pi. So can I erase this? Yeah, so I think you can leave it as pi. So 600 pi 10 power minus 7. So you can take the 0. So 6 pi 10 power minus 5. So we are finding magnetic field. So what is the unit for magnetic field? Tesla. So I think we never talked about it. So it's T, Tesla. Or you can leave it as T. So again, Tesla is a scientist name, right? So Nicholas, I think it's Nicholas Tesla. Nikola. Yeah. I think he was an American scientist. So he was the first to show that, even though we are going to study this in the next chapter, electromagnetic induction is, you know, how you produce the current. But that was done by Faraday, Michael Faraday. But then Nikola Tesla was the one who showed actually how you can produce current from the dam using that principle. So I think he used it in the, did the demonstration in Niagara Falls. So he was the one to first show that electricity can be produced in a mass scale. Okay. Somewhere near Niagara, he did that. Basically, you know, what he must have done is, the moving water, he must have made the turbine to spin. Using that, he must have connected it to the generator, to generate the electricity. We'll talk about this in the next chapters, electromagnetic induction. Okay, there is one more important question here. So they said this is due to the semicircle, right? What about this one? Is there any magnetic field due to this line? How to find that? So what we have found is only due to this semicircle. What are the magnetic field due to this straight line? Go back to the basics. So what did we say, Bayat Savart law? If I take a small dl here, right? If I want a magnetic field at this point, what should I do? I should draw the R here. Do you agree? That's what we did. So if I want to find the magnetic field at this point, R would be this one. Suppose I want the magnetic field at this point, what should I do? R will go this way. Do you agree? Everyone agreeing with this? I'm talking about the Bayat Savart law. So you took this as dl, this as some point P, and then we said this is your R vector. Remember this? So that means what I am trying to say is, if I want the magnetic field at this point, I would take the R this way. If I want the magnetic field at this point due to this dl, the R would be this way. Do you agree? Because the radius is from this point to this point, that is R. So now tell me, dl and R are, how do they look like? Angle is 0. If theta is 0, sin theta is 0. So dB is equal to u naught by 4 pi idl sin theta. So sin 0 means magnetic field due to this one will be 0. So always remember, whenever it is a straight line, this is not going to contribute any magnetic field at this point. Okay, is that clear? It will be contributing for magnetic field at other points here and all, but not at this point or anywhere in this line. Is that clear? So take it down. So B due to straight parts, what do they straight segments. So take down this diagram, only then it will make sense. Let me not do this. So dl is this way, r is also this way. So dl r are collinear. So theta is equal to 0. So sin theta is equal to 0. So dB is equal to u naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. So dB is equal to 0. Okay, because if you simply write 0, it will not make any sense. Only if you understand why it is 0, later on you can apply this concept in somewhere else. So I think that brings us to the end of topic 1. Go to topic 2, let me get started. So go to page number 138, something. Yeah, 138. Actually, I was thinking there are only topic 1 and topic 2, actually there are topic 3 is also there. So the first one is, I'm looking at page number 138. The first one is theory. You can do it. Try doing the second one. Start second and third. Try it. What about you, Ritan? You have not bought this book? No. CBSE bookshop, it doesn't have this? No. Okay, then the worst case is you will have to go for Amazon. Order it tonight. Sapnaat sir, this one?
Yes,
sir. Sure? Okay, then others go and buy it in Sapnaat. Otherwise, you will not be able to, you know, fully utilize all this, you know, knowledge. You have to practice a lot. The good news is you will see, you know, what kind of questions they are asking. 1 mark, 2 marks, everything is past paper questions. Okay, so let me erase this one. Narrow beam of protons and neutrons, each having the same momentum, enters a region of uniform magnetic field. Any idea what is neutrons? One neutron, right? So, have you studied the isotopes of hydrogen. So the first one is hydrogen, the second one is deuteron, then the third one is tritium, right? So here you have one proton, one electron, right? Here it is one proton plus one neutron and then one electron. Here it is. Okay, so you should know all these things, isotopes of hydrogen. Yeah, an electron is also there. Okay, so now they are comparing. So sometimes, right, sometimes even this one we just call it as proton. Why? There is only one proton and we kind of, you know, tend to ignore this electron. We don't even consider it as a entity, right? So sometimes we call this as proton. Okay, so this is proton, this is deuteron. So that means mass of proton is kind of very heavy compared to the mass of electron, or in other words, mass of electron is very very small, 2000 times smaller than proton. So that's that is one of the reasons why we don't care much about the electron's mass. Okay, so whenever you are calculating the mass of an atom, right, we calculate only the mass of proton and neutrons. Is that clear? So make a note, mass of proton is heavy, mass of electron is light, and 2000 times, approximately 2000 times lighter than so MPE is 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 kg. ME is 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg. So if you see, it's a order of magnitude smaller, right? So if you do the math, it, I think it will come around 1800 or something. So approximately 2000 times lighter. So that's the reason we don't care about the mass of electron when you're calculating the mass of atoms. So read the question. It says a narrow beam of protons and deuterons, each having the same momentum. Each having same momentum. So how do I translate it into mathematics? MV, that's correct. So one more step I can go as, momentum is represented as small p. Capital P is pressure, small p is momentum. Remember? So p of proton is equal to p of deuteron. That's the first sentence they have said. Each having the same momentum. So what you said was also true. So I should say mass of proton into velocity of proton is equal to mass of deuteron into velocity of deuteron. Is that clear? So we are just translating whatever is given there in the question. Enters a region of uniform magnetic field directed perpendicular to their direction of momentum. So what are they saying is, you have some magnetic field like this into the paper, right? What do you mean by direction of momentum? It will be same as the direction of velocity, right? M into V, M does not have any direction, so it will be the direction of velocity. So that means the direction of momentum is going to be this way. So let's say the velocity is coming like this. So this is for MP. Let's say there is one more thing which is MD. So two things, protons and deuterons are coming inside the magnetic field which is perpendicular to this, right? That's what they said so far. Perpendicular to their direction of momentum. What would be the ratio of radii of the circular path described by them? So they are asking, you know that when this comes in, what did we say? It's going to take a circular path. Remember this theory? So that means here also it's going to take a circular path. So they are asking you to find the radius, ratio of the radii. Okay, so what is asked is radius of proton divided by radius of deuteron is what is asked. Okay. This is given, this is one in between sentence and this is asked. Okay. unless you convert it into maths and drawing, you cannot solve these problems. So, anybody remember the relationship between velocity and radius? Q? QBR by M, very good. So, if I don't remember right, so the easy method is centripetal force is equal to magnetic force. What is magnetic force? Lorentz force, right? QVB. So, if I don't know this, this is what I would do. VB cancels. So, if I want B, QBR divided by M. Okay. So, my suggestion is you don't have to mug up this formula, but if you know the principle, you can arrive at this very quickly. Okay. So, whenever I say these are all important things, you should make a star and try to remember this. Centripetal force is equal to magnetic force, QVB. So, that means I know V in terms of this. So, let's go back to this one. So, I said P of proton is equal to P of neutron. VP, velocity of proton is equal to mass of neutron, velocity of neutron. Okay, let's come back to this theory here. One proton, one neutron. So, what can you say about the mass of proton and neutron? They are almost same. Neutron is slightly heavier, but for our usual calculations, right, we would take it as same. So, that means here you have one proton plus one neutron. So, I am going to write it as 2 times mass of proton. Do you agree? Here it is only one proton. Here it is proton plus neutron. Right? Vp is equal to Vd. So, Mp, Mp cancels. So, I get Vp by Vd. In the test notebook, I saw many of you still don't know how to write the subscript. I told you many times, still you folks are writing like this. Is this the way you should write Vp? This is vice president, right? This is Vp means you should write it as like this. You don't know how to write the subscript still. Even the very important calculations you have written, you know, ME for mass of electron, you have written like this, many of you. So, Vp by Vd is equal to 2. Okay. So, I found the relationship or the ratio between velocity as 2. Come back to this. So, I am going to say Vp is equal to QBR divided by M. But this is for proton. Okay, carefully listen. So, this is charge of one proton. Right? Charge of one proton is Qp. Let's say Qp, or you can write this E. E is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, right? For electron it is minus, for proton it is plus. So, B is same for both the cases. R is Rp, M is Mp. Anybody having any issues? If you want, you can write this as E. And then let's write Vd. So, Vd is equal to Qd. What is the charge here? I have one proton, one neutron. What is the charge? Is it 1 or 2? 1, right? Neutron does not have any charge. Which means the charge is going to be same as this one. Magnetic field is same, right? It's coming into the same magnetic field. Radius of P, this is radius of D. Divided by, this is mass of proton here, this is mass of neutron. Are you following what I'm saying? So, I know this by this, I want Rp by Rd is what I want. So, what can I do? I can divide this by this. Mass of neutron is proton plus neutron, which means it will be 2 times Mp. Qp, Qp cancels, Bb cancels, Mp, Mp cancels. So, 2 goes on the top. So, it will be 2 Rp by Rd. So, 2, 2 cancels. So, I get Rp by Rd is equal to 1. But as I said, since it is ratio, I should write it as 1 is to 1. What does that tell you? Even though the mass is different, right? Still, the radius taken is same. Same length.
They are moving velocities v1 and v2 respectively in the same direction, enters the same magnetic field B, acting normally to their direction of motion. If the two forces FA and FB acting on them are in the ratio 1 is to 2.
So the forces acting on A and B are 1 is to 2. So FA by FB is equal to 1 is to 2. So this is what they are given. Find the ratio of their velocities. So we are supposed to find V1 by V2 is equal to what? So this is given, this is asked. Anybody still copying this? Can I erase this? Quick. So you know the formula, right? What is the force? Force due to magnetic field formula? Lorentz force, QVB, right? So substitute it, do it for QVB for A, QVB for A, B, substitute it and you will get the answer. It's very simple. Are you done? Are you done? Still writing. Quick. Getting 1 is to 1? Okay, let's try that. So Q, V, B. So A, magnetic field is same. Q, V, B. So B, B. B, B cancels. Q, A is Q and 2Q. So that means Q by 2Q. V, A by V, B. So V1 by V2 is what is asked. Is equal to 1 by 2, right? According to this. So QQ cancels, 2-2 cancels, so yeah, V1 by V2 is also equal to 1, 1 is to 1. Okay, very simple. So your homework is, take it down. So whoever is serious about their studies,